So there is a myth that Six Sigma can only be used for manufacturing department, but this is a myth. So what is the fact? So Six Sigma can be used in all the sectors and department. This is one of the very, very big fact we have. So in the last module of this course, we will discuss case studies where we would be discussing how Six Sigma can be implemented in marketing, HR, finance, these sectors. But to discuss here, I would say, like for example, there is a human resource department in a company, and when they plan to recruit new people, they take 2 hours assessment as first round. Then there is a second round, which is again a technical interview round. Then there is a third round. Then there is a fourth round. There is a lengthy process. And what they do, they are calling, for example, 10 people for a job where there are 2 openings. So what is happening? They are getting wrong feedback from the candidates who did not get selected. They were like, the company wasted this much time. They could judge us with a better process, so that there is a time saving for the company as well, for the candidates as well. So this is one case which can be taken for up to apply or to as a Six Sigma project, where there is a wastage of time for both, plus there is a defect in the process, right? So this is one very, very small and basic example. Another example we can take for the finance department is that there is an insurance company which is doing 10 policies in a month. So what is the reason behind it? 10 is a very, very less number. So when we dig out the reason for that, we get to know that there are issues in the forms they are giving to the customers to fill in. When they get the forms, those forms are either incorrect, there is no validation in the form, or probably when they are collecting the forms from the customers, they are not checking what all documents they are submitting. So when they start processing the policies, then they are calling back to the customers for their Aadhaar card, for their PAN card, and this and that. So this is happening. So in case we collect those document in one go and then process the policies, then we will see that we are doing 20 to 25 policies per month, right? So this is another example where we can implement Six Sigma methodology and improve the process, and I would say remove the defect in the process. So basically, you need to identify such cases in your organization in case you are a working professional, or in case you are a student, you can take a hypothetical case. You can Google to find out the case as well. So this is all about how you are looking at a problem. So basically, the first step would be to identify the problem in your department and then check if you can implement Six Sigma there. So I would say, in case there is a defect and there is a problem in the process, yes, we can go ahead with the Six Sigma implementation. So when we will be discussing the case studies and we will discuss 4 or 5 such cases, you will get a better idea that what kind of problem you can choose.